There's so many people that are blaming you or saying that you were responsible.
Yes.
That's why he's here.
I swear to him that I would not say nothing because he made me swear.
So first of all, I keep hearing I'm the father. So first of all, your dad passed?
Yeah.
He's here because he said to me, Matt, my whole family is here to come and see me, he said to me. And he goes to me, Matt, would you believe that my family is dragging me to something like this and making me speak, he said. And I got to tell you something, your father, like he's got this, it's so funny because when I'm connecting with him, it always had to be his way here in this world when I'm connecting with him. I can't believe he goes that now I have to do what my family wants. I have to come through to a medium. I have to tell all my business, he's telling me. But first of all, he wants to thank you all for the prayers that you said even before you got on this. He tells me that you were praying that he was coming through and you had like little conversations with him. And he says, Matt, I could not disappoint my family. I had to let my family know that I'm here. This is what's crazy. When I'm connecting with your husband, there's a lot that's here. And when I'm connecting with him, he also says to me, survivor's guilt when I'm connecting. He tells me that you have so much guilt about having to watch him pass over having to watch him leave this world. And more importantly, he says to me, Matt, I need to tell her, I'm sorry for fighting with her. Because before he died, he tells me that his moods were all over the place and his moods were up and down, up and down, up and down. He said, Matt, I said things and I did things that I shouldn't have here in this world. What's also interesting is this. I see that before your husband had died, he knew that there was something seriously wrong with him. I see when I'm connecting, I feel like he went to the doctors and they wanted to do testing on him or wanted to do more tests on him.
Yes.
And I see that he walked out. I keep seeing a doctor's appointment that he walked out of. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Because I see your husband, I see them saying, we found something. We don't think this is good. We don't think this is no. And I see your husband saying, I don't care. I'm not doing this. And I see him walk out.
Yes.
Please know that he's coming through for you. Because this was the hardest thing. You keep questioning, did I do the right thing by him? Should I have made him go in to see doctors? Should I have made him go in for a procedure? Should I have made him do any of these things? And what's so tough, I have to tell you that he tells me that there's all, because I keep hearing all these questions about the way that he died. And more importantly, there's so many people that are blaming you or saying that you were responsible.
Yes.
That's why he's here.
Because his parents don't talk to me no more because I think they're mad with me because I didn't let them know. And I swear to him that I would not say nothing because he made me swear.
He says to me this. He tells me, Matt, please let her know that she doesn't owe anybody an explanation. That's what he tells. And he tells me that you feel so bad because you want to have a relationship with his family. And you keep saying, oh my God, what did I do? Did I break apart this family? Maybe I should have said something. Maybe I should have done this. Maybe I should have done that. He said to me, that was my family, not yours. That's what he tells me. He says, and what he is acknowledging to you, he said, I did not want anyone to make me go to the doctors, to change my thoughts, to do anything different. At the end of the day, you respected his wishes. And that's what he needs you to know. But the one thing that he also says to me is he goes, Matt, please tell my wife that I wish that we would have had more time together here in this world. He says, I didn't expect to go so quickly. I didn't expect to go so fast. But what I can tell you is that I did not want to go. Okay, so tell me, I did not want to leave this world hooked up to any type of machines, on life support, anything like that. So he says to me that he wants to thank you for the way that you stuck by him. And he wants to thank you for the way that you took care of him every single day. He says, because Matt, she didn't leave my side. And I see that there were times when you would not leave the house because you were afraid of leaving him alone and leaving him by himself. And he also tells me that you've been praying for his soul every single day. He says, Matt, the one thing that I didn't want is I didn't want to leave this world and leave her with a mess. And that's what you feel. You feel like you're in this mess that you can't get out of since his passing.
Yeah.
He says to me, Matt, she loved me unconditionally. And I have to let her know it's coming from my mouth and no one else's that she did nothing wrong. But I also have to tell you this. He says to me, he has to come through for you, not just because of what's going on with his family, but to let you know that he's truly there. Because I see that you have such a hard time going to sleep at night without him there. He shows me that you've had a hard time sleeping in the bed. And at one point you didn't want to sleep in the bed.
Yes. Yes.
And he also says to me, what I have to let her know is this. She gave me a beautiful life here in this world. He said, and we had such amazing moments together. Now that I'm in spirit, he says, I'm still a part of her life, living life just in a different way. He says, but I'm with her every single moment. There's one thing that he's bringing up that I'm not understanding, okay? Do you have blankets of his here in this world?
Yeah.
Blanket.
The thing upstairs.
Man. Yes.
He's telling me anytime you're missing him, he says, cuddle up to the blankets, tell them about the blankets, Matt. And he also says to me,
It's like a prayer blanket he gets in the hospital, and he used to cover with it in the hospital.
So you took that in the from the hospital after he passed? Yeah. That would be what it is. So no, it's his way of bringing that through. He wants to thank you at the end for getting everybody there to see him. He needs you to know that. And at the end of the day, I got to tell you something. Your husband was like old school here in this world. He keeps telling me he didn't want to travel. He didn't want to do anything. He didn't want to leave the house. Yes. He says to me, when I was here, Matt, he goes, the one thing that I wish, he goes, is I wish that I was more flexible. I wish that I just did things. He says, but to me, he goes, I was simple. All I cared about was being with my family. Yes. He says, I didn't care about going out to dinner. I didn't care about going on vacations, doing any of these things. But do you know that he tells me that those are opportunities that he wants you to have now with your kids? He says to me when I'm connecting, Matt, tell them to do things as a family. Tell them to enjoy one another. That's what he's telling me. And I have to tell you one thing. He tells me when I'm connecting with him that you're so upset because every day in private, you talk to him and you say, how am I going to do this without you? What am I going to do with your kids? Your kids need you. He tells me this. He says, Matt, the only person my children needed was her. That's who they needed. He said, so when I left this world, he tells me the reason why I was such at peace when I left was because I knew that I didn't have to worry about a thing. He says, I knew that my kids were in good hands because I know what a woman that you are. He's bringing that through. I also have to come to you as his son. He wants to thank you for helping your mom with the house. I have to tell you that. And by the way, what the hell is it? Are you like redoing the house for your mother? He showed me you painting. How do you connect with the painting?
Yes.
He goes to me, Matt, when did my son become so handy? He tells me. He goes, I didn't think that he knew anything but listening to music, he tells me. Yes. And now he goes to me, my son, I see him painting and trying to like redo the house and whatnot. And your father goes, if I would have known that you were that gift, he goes, I would have had you do that when I was here. Yes. So know that as you're redoing the house and doing those little things, know that your dad tells me that he sees that in spirit and that he is so, so happy about that. He also tells me what's so crazy is that you're also thinking about a tattoo in memory of him.
Yes.
So how do you connect with a tattoo?
I had a tattoo of his name on it. It was Q Dog. And my name is, his name is Sin Q. So that's what I was planning on getting.
He says to me, please let my son know I'll be with him when he gets the tattoo. He thinks that's the coolest thing, by the way. Because he says to me, I can't believe he's doing this. So know that it's his way of letting you know in spirit that he is there and with you. He is watching over you and that he is safe and at peace. All right. I'm going to leave you guys with that.